Kit, congratulations from everybody at the football club. We're delighted that you've been given the managerial position full time. I know that Mr. Khan was here with you a little while ago and also yesterday. And can you tell us a little bit about how it happened and what was said?
Well, I got the call to go and meet the owner in a hotel in London. We sat down with more a chat than a formal interview. But at the end of it, he let me know that he wanted me to take over on a full-time basis, which was obviously the news I've been desperate to hear for a long time. But saying that, I've been fully understanding of the process that was in place, and I think it makes it better for me now to have got the job in that way. I would have liked it straight away, as I think everyone can understand. But the fact that it had to go through this process, or this was the right way to do it, and then I still got the job, means an awful lot. You know, I know, without naming names, I know there's some very, very high profile, good candidates who wanted this job, as you would expect. It's a fantastic job for someone. But luckily it's a fantastic job for me, and I won through, and I'm absolutely delighted.
But I think the process here, you've got to understand, I think the committee, they were charged with coming up with a group of candidates, interviewing the candidates, and then really recommending, a couple of people. But Kit is the only one I've spoken to, and the only one, we've offered the position to.
I think, as with all managers, when they take over a job, you came in, you had a game very quickly after you took over as caretaker. You've now got 3 games in succession in the league and very important football matches, and the chairman will be at 2 of them, of course, next week. But it all starts on Saturday at Wigan.
That's right, and I went up to watch Wigan on last Saturday against Derby, where they played very well and were worthy winners. So again, we know it's going to be a very tough game, as they all are in the Championship, but Wigan have got some very, very good ball players as well, and they're a good side. So again, we'll have to be at our best to come away with a positive result, but like every game, I'm confident we've got the players and we've got the ability to do that.
Certainly statistically, we're not eliminated from the top 6, so I think we and Kit really is bought into this. We have to go in there, we've got to get the club energized, where every game we go in is a must win for us.
We've had a fixture in the Capital One Cup against Derby where the first 45 minutes was exceptional football from Fulham, and whilst the goals were a little fortuitous, there were opportunities and chances created that actually 2-0 would have been a fair scoreline at half time. As it was, 2-1 put a different complexion on the game in the second half, and that was particularly disappointing to concede so many goals in such a short space of time.
Well, it was obviously the second one went in within 2 minutes of the restart, and then there was what looked like could have been a capitulation. They scored then the third, fourth and fifth goals very quickly, which was very disappointing to say the least. But then the pleasing thing then was, with about 30 minutes still to play, the boys sort of regrouped, and then we were very much in that period of the game, and there was sort of chances either end, as you would expect to normally happen. But what was disappointing was, to concede sort of 4 goals in such a short space of time. But also, it's what doesn't kill the players makes them stronger, and there's a lot of young players, a lot of inexperienced players there who need to learn. We saw at times some fantastic play in the first half, and that the potential is certainly there, and that potential's not been reached yet, not fully fulfilled. But we'll keep plugging away, keep working with the players, and we'll get there. So it's I'm very mindful of the fact that 90 minutes was too long for some people at this level, at this stage of their careers, which is fine, it's understandable. So
will that be very much part of Kit Symons' long-term strategy in terms of the integration of those younger players, giving them football, giving them their chance when the need arises, but also being able to nurture them slightly because they're still young, they're still learning their trade?
Yeah, but brilliant. And this, the experience from Tuesday night and losing to a very good Derby side on the night was, won't do them any harm at all. In fact, it'll only do them good, and only do the football club good in the long term. I don't like losing games of football, and I certainly don't like conceding that many goals in a game. But in the greater scheme of things, it's not the worst thing that's happened to this football club in a long way. And in fact, if anything, it could be a positive. And I think it's quite clear. We know where we are, and we know what we've got to work with. And I'm confident of doing the juggling, the balancing to to make sure we get results on the pitch.
And the cliche of the league is my priority. Actually, it's not a cliche because that is the actuality of it. The league is more important to Fulham Football Club and to the future of Fulham Football Club.
Well, I think, you know, without a doubt, having taken over with 1 point from seven games, that was always going to be the main concern. And, you know, fantastic on Friday night for everyone, beating Charlton, moving out of the bottom three. But we want to move further away from the bottom three, you know. A couple of defeats and suddenly you're back in it before you know it. So one swallow doesn't make a summer, that's for sure. And it needs to be a genuine and steady rise up the table, you know. If people start patting themselves on the back too soon and complacency starts creeping in, you know, we'll be in trouble again before we know it. So that's something I won't allow to happen, certainly with myself and the staff and nor with the players. You know, we're doing okay, but we need to do better, always need to do better, keep improving continually, and then we'll be okay. We intend to and aim to improve every single week, and certainly not beyond the realms by any stretch. And we'll set our standards and set our targets very, very high. I set my own personally, and we'll set the same for the players, and they will buy into it, and we will do well.
In the press conference we were just part of, Mr. Carr made it clear that he wants to get back into the Premier League, and you talked about the playoffs not being an unrealistic expectation. Is that what you're targeting now with the group of players that you have, and that's what the talk will be about, reaching that position?
Well, I think we'll have initial chat about that. That's what the aim is, without a doubt. You know, the chairman bought a Premiership football club, Premier League football club, and he wants it back in the Premier League, and understandably so. That's what we all want. It's without a doubt be a big ask, but it's not beyond the realms. I'll mention that to the players initially, and then talk of that will be done then. You know, we'll be fully focused on improving every game. That's the big thing. And you know, the winning and where you end up is a byproduct of doing the right things. And I've said that since I was managing the under-18s. You know, if you focus just on the winning of a game, when you do win it, sometimes you can be pleased with that, even if the performance wasn't good enough. I focus on sort of reaching the standards that have been set every single week, and if anything, trying to raise that bar. If you focus on that, then you get the results and the performances, and then you continue to win, in my opinion.
I think the results speak for themselves. And I think the environment, the mood, the spirit, you know, if you were there or you watched it on television, I think you know that. And how it's really improved and intensified for the better, you know, it's pretty self-evident.
It's a great day for you, and also just in terms of your Fulham career, your career holistically. With three games coming up, you haven't really got very much time to have a big smile on your face until you're in the dugout again on Saturday. Did you have a little celebration last night?
No, not really. I got home and I had a million text messages and phone calls and things I had to answer. And so no, I've not had a chance, and I probably won't have a chance now because the games come thick and fast, and it's straight into it. So, you know, I'm not too worried about that. It's the job what gives me the greatest joy, and I want to really get stuck into it.
I've done a lot of different jobs, so I've done my apprenticeship, if you like, and I've been ready for a little while now. You know, it's no secret this is a club that's very close to my heart, and this is a job I've always, you know, really, really wanted to do. And so to get that opportunity is fantastic for me, and I intend to take it fully.
And the fans have been singing your name for the last few games now. For them, a word?
Thank you very much. You know, without a doubt, I think the support from the fans and from everyone at the football club has played a big part in me getting this opportunity. So very, very grateful to everyone.
Onwards and upwards.
Thank you.